Good morning to all of you. It is a pleasure to be here with you this morning to open the second International Dialogue on Migration of 2019. This meeting will build upon the excellent discussions that began in February of this year in New York, which explored the role of young migrants in the development of migration policy and governance. At the first IDM, we heard a strong call for the mainstreaming of the concerns of young people into the migration strategies for countries of origin, transit, and destination, including national diaspora strategies and efforts to foster integration and social inclusion. This is not yet a straightforward task. It is important to distinguish the needs of young migrants from the general needs of all migrants. But there is no universal definition of youth and little reliable evidence on the migration of young people and their specific situations and needs. In February, we heard the call from all of you to begin disaggregating data by age in order to ensure we have the most accurate understanding of what young migrants indeed need. In addition, in order to include the perspective of migrant youth in our policies, we also need to include them in our own conversations. In the words of Mrs. Jayatma Vikramanayake, UN Secretary General Envoy on Youth, in February, I quote, "There is a need to empower and create the space for young people to participate in civic and political debates." Young people possess valuable skills and innovative thinking that can contribute to both their origin and host communities and to help build solutions to problems. They possess digital literacy and the critical knowledge of new technology, and as migrants have displayed skills that are essential to the 21st century labor market, such as resilience and adaptability. They can be agents of change, whether working towards the achievement of critical sustainable development goals on education, employment, and reducing inequality, or bringing their personal knowledge and experience to bear on narratives that might offer a more positive, forward-looking image of migration and its role in society. Sadly, at the same time, we must remain cognizant of the tremendous stress, both psychological and physical, that the migration journey can place on young people, particularly those more vulnerable to exploitation and who find themselves in the hands of human traffickers. This is particularly the case of young women and girls who find themselves marginalized on the three counts of age, gender, and migration status. Strong policies to protect all children that can take into account the specific challenges faced by those who move across borders should be, I believe, high on all of our agendas. In February, a number of recommendations were made, in addition to those which I have just highlighted. Our task here today and over the next several days is to build on this. And I want to thank my co-fellow panelists for sharing with me the stage in setting the scene for our debates in the days to come. Some of the questions that will be asked include how to better use technology for youth development and reduce its potential harmful effects, how to promote cooperation between countries of origin and countries of destination for on the empowerment of youth, conversely, how to harness the adaptive resilience of youth migration to promote development, how to prepare young migrants for the future labor market at home and abroad, and invest more deeply in the skills that will be more in demand in the future. These issues are, I do recognize, wide-ranging and complex. I do not envy you your task. But IOM is not the only organization asking some of these questions. Indeed, in April 2019, the African Union launched the 1 million by 2021 initiative, which aims to direct investment towards millions of African youth in the areas of employment, entrepreneurship, education, and engagement through leveraging partnerships and private sector opportunities. This is a wide-ranging endeavor that looks at the development of startups, establishment of internships and apprenticeships, and nurturing leadership skills in young people. We will have the opportunity to discuss the potential of this initiative for migrant youth alongside the presentation of the first ever Africa Migration Report, a report that aims to rebalance the conversation about African migration away from the dominant yet overly narrow narrative of irregular migration to Europe. African youth are not only a large part of the conversation regarding how migration within the continent will evolve, they will be one of the prime determinants of its success. The deliberations we undertake here this week will feed into other conversations within IOM and influence our own work in many of these areas. To be effective, IOM needs to be an organization that can listen as well as act. The IDM is a unique platform, as it has been recognized by the Marrakesh Pact on Safe, Orderly and Regular Migration. The IDM is a unique platform that brings governments, NGOs and academic experts together to debate and ideally innovate with respect to policy and practice. As we have seen at the recent UN General Assembly, most particularly in the session dedicated to climate, we should not ignore the voices of young people, especially when they challenge the norms and assumptions of older generations. And we certainly should not fear them, even when the urgency and clarity of their concerns may belie our own slow-grown cynicism. As we near the end of 2019, we will begin to explore potential topics for our dialogues next year in 2020. And I take this opportunity to tell you that IOM welcomes your own ideas on what subjects we should focus on in our IDM dialogue next year. In doing so, we will draw upon some of the issues outlined in the forthcoming World Migration Report that IOM will launch in December in our own council, and identify those that will be the most used to our policy work going forward. In the meantime, I hope this discussion proves as fruitful and fascinating as our IDM in New York. Of course, Geneva cannot stay behind New York. And I invite you all to actively contribute to our discussions here today, particularly those amongst you who have youth on your side. Thank you.